Rabbi, seeking for the shir and talking during davening, when is it mutter? There's no talking during the seeking.
Yes, we learned today, Baruch Hashem, the unusual chaymer of talking by davening, more so chazar shashats, and especially kriyas haTorah, but basically, there are more than a half a dozen reasons why we don't talk in any part of davening. We miss part of davening, it's a bezayin to the shechina, disturbs others, causes a rifya and a kalkite in the davening, the kedushas beis hamedrash, and also the chil Hashem that shows that we don't have the proper attitude to what we're doing, to the shechina, to the beis hamedrash, to the davening itself, and therefore we don't turn around when we finish Manasseh to see who's still davening, because it disturbs us. That's Allah and Raman Shulchan Aruch. Today there's no heta of meishiv me'asholim, even though it's a Mishnah and a Mechaba. The Chinuch already says, Mr. Burr's Lashon is Chalila, to rely on this heta. Obviously there's a certain emphasis on not talking under any circumstances. A person has to stop someone from talking, a Rebbe, a counselor, or a Gabi in Shul, that's mutter to talk during Chodav Shashatz. Mouthing words, which means just moving your lips without pronouncing them, even though Lamaisa it's not audible, that's considered a dibur, and that's a hefsik. Texting is obviously wrong in the middle of davening. Talking on a phone is something that's unfathomable, how people could do that during davening. It's the contempt of Shechina, like we said. But basically, even after Baruch Hu, before one started Ma'ariv, you're not allowed to talk, even though you might think, well, I didn't start davening, but the Baruch Hu is the beginning. The Siyas Kapayim has to be fully focused on the Bracha, no Hesach Hadas. The Talis that we cover ourselves with is to prevent Hesach Hadas. Shouldn't be something that brings more Hesach Hadas when we try to chop the children, grandchildren, crying children. It has to be something that's going to eliminate the distractions. Talking, even when there's no Issa Hefsik during Kabbalah Shabbos, during Ashiva Olatzian, is also disturbing. Between the Shtilan and the Chazara, Shachris or Mincha, should not be done any talking at that time. Just like we don't talk between Shemoneh Esrei and Tachna, we don't talk between the Shtilan and the Chazara for many reasons. Even by Meir, where there's no Chazara, but there's still the Kaddish Tiskabel. Leil Shabbos, not to talk during from Shemoneh Esrei until the end of Davening, because there's a Shtilan, there's a Me'ein Sheva like the Chazara Sashatz. Chazara Sashatz certainly should be a zero tolerance attitude. We see a lot of mevayis someone. You're supposed to mevayis someone, Rabbi, if he talks. The Prima Godim didn't want to hear any excuses regarding putting on tefillin Rabbeinu Tam during Chazar Sashatz. So it's basically something that we have to be focused fully on the Chazar Sashatz. Even learning is definitely not the right thing. Might not be osa goma, but it's definitely not the right thing. But certainly talking is wrong. A collecting during Chazar Sashatz, halavayit should be avoided. Lightning and thunder, again, could be if you hear it, you have to answer. But we can't say it's a chiyuv. The three, we do see a heta b'mokam mitzvah, which is very limited. It has to be a mitzvah, iveres, nechutza, during Chazar Sashatz, paskin ashayla, lafusha meisura. But even that is only after akela kaddish, because that's the conclusion of the kedusha. Kaddish is even more chomer than Chazar Sashatz, even hearer is also, because you have to hear the kaddish, not just answer. And laning has its own chomer, oizvi Hashem yichlu, dvar Hashem boza. We never leave during laning, even if you heard laning, and certainly if you didn't hear laning, you have to stay for the laning. Talking, even for dar mitzvah, even lahiras psak halach is asa, it's more chama than chazar sashatz. The only heter is if there's a shayla that can't wait, a pikuach nefesh, or a shayla on the Torah itself. The only heter we saw, if someone is potter from laning, maybe there's no oizvi Hashem yichlu. We could apply that to Nashim, don't have a chi of laning, so they're allowed to daven during laning, not to talk, but daven during laning. Talking disturbs others. They could walk out, attend to a child during laning, that's certainly okay, because there's no oizvi Hashem yichlu by Nashim. Halavai, they wouldn't be collecting during laning. Lightning and thunder also shouldn't be done during the brachon. Lightning and thunder should not be done during laning. And basically, during Chazar Shatz, there has to be a total Chazar Shatz, laning, and of course, Kaddish has to be a total devotion to what we're doing. We did have a question about those that finish davening and the back of the Beis Medrash. Can they do what they're doing, learning or talking or eating by a tikkun, for example? Hopefully there's some type of heta. It's like a different makom, but l'chayr and svar, it should not be done. It definitely should be avoided. And I should mention wishing mazal tov during Muslim Chazar Sashatz is not right. Even though you davened already, but it's disturbing others, the Baal Tefillah, the Baal Simcha has a problem, are you allowed to respond or not? So better wait until Chilul Shatz is over and not during Kaddish either. That brings Simcha, you have to do things Kalocha, and wait till you have to davening. Go to